discovering treatments and a cure for ALS to serve, advocate, and empower people affected to their lives, to live their lives fullest has led to over 150,000 ALS supporters nationwide, and the organization hopes for more to participate in this year's local walk toward finding a cure. Here to share more information on the ALS organization is Kelly Murrie. Thanks for being here, Kelly. How's it going?
Absolutely. I'm happy to be here.
First, let's talk about you. What is your role with the organization? How long have you been involved?
Sure. So this is my 11th year. I have been a team captain for Team Tammy Hardy. I've also been involved with getting walk efforts underway. And my law firm, Dowd Bennett, has been a major contributor and a presenting sponsor for the walk since I came to the firm in 2012.
And what brought you into it initially? Is there a personal connection with this disease?
There is. My older sister, Tammy Hardy, she was diagnosed with ALS at the age of 33, and she passed away 6 years later at the age of 39.
Oh, that's incredible. So maybe for the audience members who aren't familiar with what ALS is, can you just describe kind of what the diagnosis is, maybe what occurs to the patients?
Sure. ALS is a neurological disease. It affects both muscles and nerves, and the progression is really difficult. With my sister, for example, so she was 33 at the time, a very active individual, a runner, and for her, she started getting clumsy. She had a couple trips, a couple falls, and it really happens with many neurological disorders. It's a process of elimination. So after months of doctor's appointments and tests, she finally got her diagnosis. And then ALS, it works such that it's degenerative, and it slowly paralyzes its victims. So it deprives them of their ability to walk, to move, to speak, and eventually to swallow and to breathe. So as a family member watching someone go through that, it really is, it's very traumatic, it's difficult. Particularly because these people go from such healthy, you know, vibrant lifestyles to really being prisoners in their own bodies.
Correct, right. I actually do have an uncle as well who has passed away, Mark Donovan, a couple years ago, passed away from ALS. And having watched him need new equipment so quickly to be able to live his life, how do patients who maybe can't afford all this new stuff that they need, I mean, a lot of the public doesn't even realize maybe you need a machine to help you get out of bed every day.
No, you're exactly right. So the progression can be quick. The average lifespan after diagnosis is only 2 to 5 years, but it's 100% fatal. And the day-to-day existence for these individuals who are slowly becoming more and more paralyzed, it lends itself to the need of a walker, a chairlift, a stairlift. With my sister, we had a specially equipped van that had a ramp for her wheelchair. You know, all of that to some carefully crafted devices that we came up with that would hold her, you know, her coffee cup where she could reach it. But you're right, the average cost is, you know, upwards of a couple $100,000. It can be out of pocket for families without coverage to provide these needs, and it's overwhelming.
Does your organization help out with patients that do have a hard time affording it, or is there
Absolutely.
Other places they can go to help?
Yeah, so the ALS Association, and that's part of what the walk we're having on Saturday is designed to do to raise funds for this, but they provide much-needed patient services. They're able to provide nutritional supplements for patients who have trouble swallowing. And more than that, you know, I think as you can hear from what I'm describing, it's a family disease. These patients require round-the-clock care. And so they're able to provide the ALS Association family members with respite care and support and public education. It's a great organization filled with some really wonderful people.
Now, the disease is hereditary or not?
So the cause is unknown. There are families who have greater instances of it. For example, I have a cousin who was recently diagnosed as well, a young father. Military veterans, for example, are twice as likely to get it. But there's still a lot that's unknown, and it's particularly important why research dollars are needed.
Well, we'll definitely be talking more about this and the run walk coming up. So stay with us at STL Live. We'll have more with the ALS organization right after this.